have a lot of anxiety and fear and concern about attempted murder. These are not things that happen very often here, and so that leads to the anxiety and the challenges that we face when something like this does occur. I want to thank our community for their patience, for their vigilance, for their assistance. We received many, many tips from community throughout this ordeal that allowed us to continue to follow up and identify where Mr. Santos was during our search of him. I want to thank them especially for the patience. This was a difficult case, and I'll explain a little bit about that in just a few minutes. But most importantly, I want to thank them for their continued support for our law enforcement community. This is a very small community, a very interconnected community. And the level of support and understanding that our community provided to us throughout this entire ordeal, I know gave our officers and our law enforcement personnel the energy and the fuel to continue to do what was so critical for us to do safely, and that was to take Mr. Santos in custody. I also want to thank the men and women and all the law enforcement organizations that are represented here for their diligence, their hard work, many, many, many hours that they put into the last 10 days to get this solution resolved peacefully. We couldn't have done it without the support of our partners who are represented here today by the U.S. Marshals and the Federal Bureau of Investigation. One of the wonderful things that we have here in our state is a very close working relationship with every member of the law enforcement community, both state and federal. And so when these types of events occur, whether they be here on Kauai or on any other island in this state, we are confident and we know that we have the support immediately of our federal and state partners. And so I just want to begin by saying thank you to each of you. We could not have done this without your support and your help. And finally, before I get into my remarks about the case, I really want to thank the men and women that tirelessly spent 12, 14, 16 hours a day committed, some of them refusing to go home until we could make sure that we made this community safe again. We could not have done it without their help. From the behind the scenes folks that assisted us in tracking down every single lead, to the tactical officers that put themselves in harm's way, to every member of the support teams that provided the equipment and everything that was necessary, from water, food, accommodations, transportation, everything that was necessary to bring this entire operation together. I just want to highlight the amazing dedication and support I have for members of the event, and make sure that we once again, this is a shining example of the true dedication that police officers and our professional support staff commit to our community every single day. I'll go through the timeline now. Obviously, this began as an investigation involving a murder and an attempted murder. On September, just a minute. On September 7th, the Kauai Police Department received information of an unattended male that was in the area of Kalihi Mountain Road. The person while the officers on scene investigated, they also located a female also with gunshot wounds. The female was transported to an area hospital where she was later released. Unfortunately, the male half, 28-year-old Keith Silva Lacro of Kalaheo here in Kauai, was pronounced deceased at the scene. On September 8th, investigators with the Kauai Police Department identified Chris Santos as the suspect in the murder and attempted murder that occurred on September 7th. An arrest warrant was issued for Chris Santos on September 10th, and on September 14th, the Kauai County Prosecutor's Office secured a grand jury indictment on Chris Santos for 5 charges. Currently, those state charges include attempted murder in the first degree, murder in the second degree, attempted murder in the second degree, carrying or use of a firearm in the commission of a separate felony, and ownership or possession of any firearm or ammunition by a person convicted of a certain. Santos driver's and put the vehicle into drive and began one of the law enforcement officers alongside the vehicle. He then struck another officer and steered toward a third officer before escaping. In that time period, Mr. Santos evaded capture for nearly 3 months. It took the efforts of the U.S. Marshals, Fugitive Task Force, and the Kauai Police Department to finally take Mr. Santos in custody. At one point, as he was eluding capture during that time period, Mr. Santos yelled in the direction of the officers as he fled, "You'll have to shoot me to take me into custody." At the time that Mr. Santos was arrested in 2007, less lethal means were necessary to get him to comply with the officers to be successfully taken into custody. Mr. Santos was recently released from federal custody in relationship to those charges. It was Mr. Santos' prior history of using force to flee from the police, his ability to elude capture, and the information that we had gathered from this murder investigation that required law enforcement to use extreme caution when attempting to arrest Santos in this murder investigation. We were very concerned about his prior violent acts towards law enforcement, his complete disregard for public safety, the information that we had that he was considered armed and dangerous. And in law enforcement, we have to work within the boundaries and constraints of our training and the law. Violent criminals who have no regard for the law, have no concern about their actions, are willing to do violent things without consideration of the consequences. And as we've seen too many times across our nation, innocent people and communities become harmed during the interactions of police attempting to take people into custody. And so it was incredibly important in this operation that every encounter or every attempted encounter to take Mr. Santos in custody, our number one priority was the safety of our public, to ensure that no innocent bystanders were injured by Mr. Santos' recklessness and his ability to use violence without thought. And that hindered our ability to take Mr. Santos into custody and created some very unique challenges that required additional assets beyond the control and availability of the Kauai Police Department. The 9-day manhunt involving more than 100 law enforcement personnel identified Mr. Santos on several occasions at various places all over the island. Mr. Santos, apparently, as we received reports from the community very frequently, did not stay in any one location for very long. He moved about quite often, utilizing different vehicles, never stayed in place for any length of time to allow law enforcement to determine whether or not that location was a viable location for us to take him into custody. And so it made it extremely difficult, as I've mentioned previously. Throughout the 9-day manhunt, officers from the Kauai Police Department and agents from the Federal Bureau of Investigation and deputy marshals from the U.S. Marshal Service, along with our state partners at the Department of Land and Natural Resources, continuously followed down every lead to identify where Mr. Santos's location was. This was truly a collaborative effort, a joint tactical operation that was operating 24 hours a day. I'm going to introduce my partners to my left and my right in just a few minutes. But before I do, I want to talk about the extraordinary cooperation that took place between all of these agencies. In my 30 plus years of a law enforcement officer, this is the first time I've had the privilege of seeing U.S. Marshals, a local police department, and the FBI all working together as one team with one mission. Everything else was set aside. This operation worked so seamlessly, it was like we were all wearing one badge. And that goes to the commitment that every member standing before us and those we represent here today have to creating the partnerships at every level of our organizations to keep our community safe. On September 17th, 2023, at approximately 2200 hours, Mr. Santos was located on the west side of Kauai in an area known as Kekaha. We dispatched teams from the Kauai Police Department, the U.S. Marshal Service, and the FBI to the area. A United States Marshal Service tactical team with KPD officers embedded with that tactical team encountered Santos near Kekaha Beach Park. Santos was operating a stolen Jeep Cherokee. Upon seeing the arriving units, Mr. Santos began to drive dangerously and erratically in the direction of law enforcement. At one point, one of the tactical team members had to take an evasive measure to ensure that Mr. Santos did not engage with their vehicle. At a last minute, the Jeep Cherokee veered off the side of the road and struck a light pole. It was at this time that members of the U.S. Marshals tactical team exited the vehicle, and Mr. Santos was subsequently taken into custody. During the engagement, Mr. Santos received at least one gunshot wound. He was transported to Wilcox Hospital for treatment, where he currently remains. It's expected he'll be released in the next 3 to 4 days and transferred to the Hawaii State Department of Corrections. A female passenger was removed safely from the vehicle, and she has been released. KPD has taken the lead in investigating the officer-involved shooting, and that investigation is ongoing. We also continue to conduct the investigation on the murder and attempted murder, and we continue to follow up on all leads and all information that we have for any individual that supported Mr. Santos in his ability to elude capture for 9 days. We've spoken as a federal contingent, as well as with our local prosecutors, and we intend to hold each of you accountable for your actions. This investigation is ongoing, and while the media attention may go away, our attention will not. At this time, I'd like to introduce U.S. Marshal Bill Jessup. I'm sorry, before I do so, I will provide an example or a photograph that will be included in the press package. This is the scene of the officer-involved shooting the following day. As you know, the officer-involved shooting occurred at approximately 2200 hours in the evening, dark evening hours. And so the scene was secured, and at first light, our team responded to investigate the scene. Thank you. Marshal Jessup.
Good morning, everybody. Aloha. I'm Bill Jessup with the U.S. Marshals. I'd like to take this opportunity to highlight the incredible relationships that exist between the Kauai Police Department, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, and the U.S. Marshals Service. Our efforts focus on bringing violent criminals to justice and keeping our community safe. And when we work in joint operations like this, this is exactly what we did. Brought a violent criminal to justice and ensured the safety of our community. Mitigating violent crime is our top priority here in the islands. So I just want to say thank you to our partners, and I want to say thank you to the people of Kauai for your continued support and friendship. Mahalo. I'd like to now turn this over to Special Agent Charge Merrill.
Good morning. I'm Stephen Merrill, Special Agent in Charge of the FBI Honolulu Division. Thank you all for joining us today. As the Marshal said, combating violent crime and mitigating criminal activities are one of the FBI's highest priorities as well, whether on cases we lead or cases which we assist. The FBI was contacted by the Kauai Police Department and the U.S. Marshals Service to assist in the location, identification, and apprehension of felon fugitive Chris Santos. Before I speak about our role, I wanted to first take a moment and thank our law enforcement partners, as the Chief and the Marshal have as well. Everyone in this operation has worked tirelessly over the past few weeks. Our collaboration is vital to our common goal, and we thank you all for your unwavering support and steadfast partnership. Thank you, Chief Raybuck. Thank you, Marshal Jessup. Upon receiving the call for assistance, the FBI immediately mobilized and deployed resources from our Honolulu field office, including our SWAT team, aviation support, special agents, and intelligence analysts. Additionally, due to the nature and the duration of the search, a team of highly trained tactical agents from across the country who stand at the ready to rapidly response were activated and deployed to Kauai. Within hours, 40 operators and 10 support staff were on the ground here in Kauai. Santos's erratic behavior, combined with frequently changing locations, phones, and vehicles, as Chief Raybuck mentioned, added to the complexity of this case. The initial wave of personnel worked tirelessly, often putting in close to 22 hours a day during the early stages of this relentless pursuit. The challenges posed by Santos, including the constant danger he presented, necessitated careful tactical planning to ensure the safety of our resources, the community, and Santos himself. Let me be quite clear, we and our partners are not going anywhere. To the public, I want to assure you that the FBI will continue to support local police to aggressively going after criminal networks and violent criminals operating in your community. The FBI is here to protect you, the American public, and your partnership is crucial as well. We applaud you for heeding warnings to lock doors, cars, sheds, and buildings while Santos was at large. While it may seem minor, activities such as these can help mitigate additional potential criminal activity. I will close with a reminder that the FBI stands proudly in our commitment to the people of Kauai. As this is an ongoing matter, if anyone has information on this case, other crimes, or criminal activity, you can please call the U.S. Marshals, the Kauai Police Department, or the FBI. The FBI number is 1-800-CALL-FBI. You can also call our local field office, or we can take tips at tips.fbi.gov. And remember, when providing information, your identity can remain anonymous. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Chief. At this time, I'll go ahead and open up for any questions that the room may have. Chrissy.
Yeah, Chief. Chrissy Thomas here from KH12 News. I think you mentioned a female passenger in the vehicle with Santos. Can you share with us who that female passenger was and why was she released?
Yeah, so at this time, I cannot release the identity. It's an ongoing investigation. And so we still continue to look at what the relationship was and what her role was. She was released as we continue the investigation.
Do you have a question from Hawaii News Now? What kind of weapons were recovered in Santos' vehicle? Were they loaded?
Yeah, so as I mentioned, at the time of the encounter with law enforcement, you know, we had repeatedly asked Mr. Santos to turn himself in peacefully to avoid any types of violence or harm. Unfortunately, Mr. Santos refused to do that. And so his actions that night led law enforcement officers to be in a place of danger when they contacted him. And it was his actions that was the cause of the an outcome of the officer-involved shooting. I cannot go into specific details as the investigation is going on, but I can confirm that two rifles were located just outside of the vehicle that Mr. Santos was taken into custody as the tactical team moved in to take him into custody.
Next question is from KITV. Why did it take so long to capture Mr. Santos?
I know a lot of people had the question about why did it take us so long to capture him. As you heard myself and my partners describe, Mr. Santos, it was not his first encounter with law enforcement. He was a very seasoned criminal who was very aware of former contacts with the police, what our limitations and abilities were, and where our vulnerabilities were lying, and he exploited every one of those, which is why I, again, cannot impress upon the gratitude I have for the support of the U.S. Marshals Service and the FBI to help us eliminate the advantages that Mr. Santos attempted to exploit. But as was said, and I'll say again, no one was going home. People were staying all night until Mr. Santos was taken into custody, and every one of us was confident that that would occur safely. Any other questions?
I've got one.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to go back to the original issuance of the arrest warrant. What was foundation for that warrant? The only thing I can come up with is the female victim, because there are no traffic cameras in that area. Certainly Mr. Santos is not going to give you any information with respect to what happened. Can you speak to that at all?
So are you asking me how was the original arrest warrant obtained for Mr. Santos, considering that it happened in a remote area without cameras? As I mentioned, it's an ongoing investigation. Obviously, we obtained enough information to identify Mr. Santos as the suspect. I'm not going to reveal how that information was obtained at this time. That information was presented to the court, who also identified that there was probable cause to believe that Mr. Santos was the individual involved in the murder and attempted murder that occurred on September 7th. Additionally, under Prosecutor Becky Leake from the Kauai Prosecutor's Office, a grand jury indictment, a statement of the facts were presented to a grand jury, a true bill was received, and so again, he was charged with five counts, as I mentioned earlier in my presentation. And just like we always say in law enforcement, everyone is considered to be innocent until they are proven guilty, and so Mr. Santos and his defense team will have their opportunity to present facts that may, you know, in their defense. Next question.
So next question is from Hawaii News Now. Given the joint operation, which agency is leading the investigation into the officer-involved shooting?
Thank you for asking. So which agency is responsible for investigating the officer-involved shooting? The U.S. Marshals Service, when they operate within the local jurisdiction, they turn over and that investigation to the local authorities. And so the Kauai Police Department is responsible for and is currently conducting the investigation on the officer-involved shooting. As I mentioned earlier, we will obtain the facts involved in that case and then present them to the county prosecutor's office for review, and a determination will be made on the outcome of those facts.
You know, back to the officer-involved shooting, can you tell us how many officers deployed their weapons, and are they on administrative leave or anything like that?
I cannot provide that information at this time. It's an ongoing investigation. This investigation involved federal law enforcement officers, or the officer-involved shooting involved federal law enforcement officers. So they also have their own internal review that will be conducted, I believe, through the Department of Justice. And those findings may be released later. I don't know what their protocols are, but that's a piece of the ongoing investigation. Next question.
I wanted to bring it back to public safety. You spoke at the beginning about the fear and anxiety across the community. Can you talk about what efforts you may have made about a shelter-in-place order, and if so, how long, and when was that lifted?
Thank you for that question. I know that we got many reports of people who were reporting that they saw Mr. Santos in the neighborhood, or in this neighborhood, or in that neighborhood. And as the police department and our partners continued to pursue those leads, there were times that we couldn't confirm that as his presence was there, or his presence was there it's for such a limited amount of time, we determined that he posed no immediate threat to the community. And so information was not passed on to the community on those situations. However, we did have two encounters where we had credible information that we believe Mr. Santos may be in the area, and that due to the increase in law enforcement response and the potential for an attempted arrest taking place in the abundance of caution, we had an incident just at the time on the west side when school was about to let out, and we had concerns that school children, school buses, parents transporting children may drive by the area where we suspected Mr. Santos was in. And so we notified the community at that time out of an abundance of caution. We dispatched police officers to our local schools to provide a solid sense of security. And so to make sure that everyone knew that law enforcement was there, and should any type of operation or Mr. Santos engage in any activity that put the community at threat or in danger, that we were there to respond. We also had another incident during this time period, and I apologize that it escapes me at the moment, where we also notified the public of Mr. Santos' suspected presence in an area. And then, of course, at the time of the arrest, we notified the community afterwards. Fortunately, at the time of the arrest, it was in a location on the island where there was not any populated area, so we weren't in need to immediately notify the community at that time. We did so once the scene was stabilized.
One more question. Back to the original incident on September 7th, what were all three people doing there?
Sir, I wasn't there. We continue to investigate, and I can't answer your question this time.
Sorry, one final question from KITV. Is anyone else being arrested or cited for helping out Mr. Santos?
So we continue to follow up. So the question was, is anyone else going to be arrested for assisting Mr. Santos elude law enforcement? And the answer is yes. We continue to follow up on leads. We continue to pursue justice. And any person who provided Mr. Santos any means, whether that be financial, transportation, communication, or otherwise, to elude law enforcement is a focus of our investigation and can count on us seeing and talking to them sometime in the near future. I want to thank everybody very much for all of your questions. Thank you for coming today. And once again, thank you to our law enforcement partners, our community, and all of the law enforcement professionals that helped this make our community safe again. Thank you. Have a good day.